with nowadays? Someone is losing a job, maybe it be your family, your friends, maybe even you. It seems like the world is really upside down right now when it comes to money and careers and security. And it really gets you thinking, what jobs are secure for the future? Are you in a job that you can have and grow in the next 5, 10 years? Or are you in a job that AI is going to take over? And really, as of recent, AI has been a huge topic of conversation, especially because of ChatGPT.
Put a sports car on the nearest table, then rotate it by 90 degrees and make it move back and forth along the surface. Place a tree frog on the nearest plane. That was super cool. Okay, put a rocket ship on the nearest table. Cool. Make it twice as big and make it lift off.
It's definitely trending, and you can see already, even with implementation of ChatGPT, how many jobs would be swept out because of this platform, such as writers, bloggers, etc. It takes over so many jobs because it can do the thinking for you. This brings you back to the question of, well, where do I find a job? What job can I get into that I will be secure and that will still be in demand in the future? Today, we are going to be covering the top 15 jobs that will be in demand not only today, but in the future. Also, we're going to put a little spin on this video and also cover the jobs that will be automated in the future. I really wanted to do both because I feel like there's a lot of videos out there that talk about the positives and make sure you get this job to grow for the future and this job. But what if you are in a job that won't be there in the future? And although these are tough conversations to have, it's important to have them so we can properly prepare for them. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content, and let's just jump right into it. Let's just get in. Let's start with the positives and then lead with the robots taking over all of our jobs. With the world going more and more digital, everything's digital nowadays, it's great because our homes are automated. We have so many IoT devices. You know, you can, from your thermostat being able to detect what temperature it is and adjust accordingly, to your coffee machine going on every morning at 8 a.m., your whole life can essentially be automated. But the problem with this is there becomes a lot more vulnerabilities that hackers can utilize to learn more about you, to spy on you, to watch you. So it's no surprise here that the number one job that will be continue to be in demand is cybersecurity engineer or cybersecurity expert. Now I really want to reframe that rather than cybersecurity engineer, but cybersecurity expert, because there could be many different roles within this category that are very in demand. But cybersecurity is something that will continue to grow and grow as tech continues to expand, and unfortunately, security risks continue to as well. Cybersecurity experts are expected to have advanced knowledge in areas such as cryptography, network security protocols, firewalls, and threat detection systems. So there's a lot to learn there. The good news is you don't need to go back to school for another 4 years to get a degree in order to get into cybersecurity. There are tons of free courses and resources online that you can start using, start networking, and building a career within cybersecurity. Okay, let's get some green screen going. You know, let's get some more visuals going. Next on the list is social media manager. And this is so funny because I feel like a few years ago, this role would have honestly been scoffed at or laughed at. Like, that's not a real job. What kind of job is that? But let's face it, social media is here and it's not going anywhere. These large influencers who are working with many different companies, many different brands, they need someone often to manage their campaigns. And this is where social media manager comes in. As a social media manager, you might manage many different influencers, not just necessarily one. This is a great role too because it can be done, well, actually all of these roles can be done from virtually anywhere. You can work right from home, right from your computer, or wherever you want. Next on the list, this is such a fun one that really merges fashion with technology, which is virtual reality designer. Yes, you heard that correctly. As more people and more companies are exploring getting into the metaverse or what that really means, what that looks like, virtual reality, the need to have designers in this space is really important. Now, what's the difference between a regular designer? Regular designer? Who thought we'd be in a world where we're saying regular designer versus digital designer? But here we are. The regular or physical designer, I guess you could call it, they are actually taking into account fitting for people's bodies, different body types. Whereas you are designed digitally, there's less worry about that as technology can handle that part, and more so about what environment people are going to be playing in. So what kind of world these characters are living in. It's a whole different realm of considerations, but it's a really fun and challenging job that we will continue to see more and more as our lives continue to be more integrated into this world. Next on the list is data scientist. And once again, I'm sure this is not a shocker, but data science is not only something that's in demand now, but as companies continue to gather more and more data, we need someone to analyze that data, be able to communicate what it means and how to utilize it in the best way possible. So not only data scientist, data analyst, anything around data, you are definitely going to be safe within in the next coming years. Next on the list is game developer, and I'm sure you were waiting for this one as video games not only are currently so in demand, but just similar to the other roles I've spoken about, they're not going anywhere. We are continuing to play more video games, to spend more time in that world, that area, and the need for game developers is continuing to grow. Now, one thing with game developers is, I'm not sure the exact stats around it, but I do believe that there is a huge shortage for game developers out there. As products continue to become more intense and more detailed, game development is a great area to specialize in. And this is one of these jobs that if you're already a developer, it's more easy to transition into game development. You do not need to go back to school and get a formal education for it. You can take a boot camp, learn online, learn on YouTube. There are so many different ways. Next on the list is user experience designer, UX designer, UI designer. Both of those, I know they're different things, but both of those are going to continue to be so in demand. Reason being is because every business nowadays is going digital and they need an expert to help with the user experience. If you have a bad user experience but a great product, very unlikely that customers will even come to you still. They'll find something else that might be maybe even less great of a product, but has a better user experience. So you can see how important user experience designers really are. Now we have this whole user experience design set up. We need someone to actually implement it. And that's where full stack developers come in. Full stack developers will continue to be so in demand in the future because, well, first of all, let me step back a step. I'm sure there's people yelling at their screen right now being like, AI is going to take over developers' jobs. Why are you including it? No. Let's take a step back and be realistic here. AI is not going to take over software engineers' jobs or developers' jobs. What it will do is it will enable us to be able to work on more complex issues. And that's really why it's so important now more than ever to be a continuous or forever learner. What you know today, the skills you possess today, will be obsolete tomorrow. Relatively speaking, but you need to continue to level up and upskill. Now, I'm not saying to spend every week, every waking moment learning something new, but rather be aware of what's trending, be aware of what's growing and what's out there. And if you find something of interest to you, stick with it and continue to grow your learnings in that direction. For example, a lot of people right now are continuing to learn about blockchain and Web3. Actually, speaking of that, that is next on our list. Blockchain developers are continuing to become more and more in demand. I'm sure you've seen articles where they're making 500,000 plus doing their jobs. Like, it's crazy how in demand they are right now, and they will continue to be. Although, you know, we hear horror stories of the crypto market and what's going on in that world. The technology, the actual blockchain technology, is not going anywhere. And I'm not saying anything else is either, but I'm saying we have to remember to really separate the two, that blockchain technology can be used for so much more than just currencies. And the companies, and the increasing number of companies that are continuing to implement blockchain technologies is huge, from healthcare to sports teams to every industry it's starting to touch. And blockchain developers, they're responsible for designing, creating, implementing distributed ledger systems that facilitate transactions between two parties without the need for the third party. So similar to how cryptocurrency works, but you can think of it used for so many other things. It's of course important to have a deep understanding as how this technology works. And one of the great things about being a blockchain developer is if you are already an engineer or a developer, it's pretty simple to get into that area of specialization if it's something of interest to you. There are so many great resources online. I mean, there is for everything I'm listing here that you literally just, I think more than anything, you need to find something you're passionate about. Next on the list is robotics engineer. As robots continue to become more and more popular, this role continues to grow as well. And it's such an interesting role. It's something that You know, if I was to do it all over again, I think robotics engineering would be such an interesting thing to explore. And to become a robotics engineer, you have to have an in-depth understanding of engineering principles and be able to apply that knowledge to the development of robotic systems. So this could include designing the robot's components, testing the system for functionality, programming it, and so much more. I really like it because it's an interesting mix between the software. You have to have software knowledge, but also hardware knowledge as well. Next on the list is virtual reality developer, and this is an area that, once again, if you are already in the tech industry and just want to specialize, it's a great area to consider. They are high in demand due to the increasing number of businesses that are looking to leverage technology for different applications. They must have in-depth knowledge and understanding of computer graphics, 3D modeling, game design and development, programming languages. You need to know something such as C++, Java, and/or Python. And they are essentially responsible for, as it sounds like, creating immersive applications for virtual reality. This is a very fun and interesting job, but I also think it's very challenging as well, which makes it one of my top ones. So what are some jobs that AI will probably take over? The first one is receptionist, and I'm sure you've seen a lot of this already, whether you're going to an appointment or checking in somewhere, seeing that a lot of times now, there is no human to contact. And similarly, this goes for cashiers. Oftentimes now when I go to a drugstore or Shoppers, I'm not sure if you have Shoppers where you're listening to this, but any kind of store where you run errands, now there everything is automated. A lot of times there might just be one person working and monitoring, but what used to be 10 people, we've seen this for years now, it's continuing to go further in that direction. The next on the list that's maybe not there quite yet, but will be very quickly, is self-driving cars. Yes, we know that cars can self-drive already. In areas they are permitted, in other areas they are not, but as it continues, this technology continues to get better and better. Things like truck drivers, taxi drivers, Uber drivers will continue to diminish at a very quick rate. And what about courier services? When you think about getting a package delivered, right now, a lot of times, yes, it's done by a person, but imagine if it was drones that are delivering all our packages, or having this kind of grid system in the sky that they are in charge of or deliver. I know I sound like I'm getting a little crazy and a little out there, but if you would have explained to someone 5 years ago even what our world looks like today, they would have thought the same thing. And this is a really interesting and fun topic to start thinking about. I say fun, but I know for some people it can be very scary because maybe you are in one of those roles. And that really brings me to sum this up, which is at the end of the day, the most important thing is to continue to level up, continue to upskill, gain new skill sets, and the best way to do that is right at your fingertips with the internet. There are so many different courses, so many different programs that it's not necessarily resources that are lacking, but rather what is lacking is you need to find your passion, and the best way to do that is spend a few different days or a few different hours of a day really understanding where you get passionate, what excites you. You know, maybe watch a video on blockchain, maybe watch a video on data science. See what that spark is for you and explore it. Just because you commit to one thing today doesn't mean you need to do it in 20 years from now. And that's the beauty of the world we live in, is I think our roles and our jobs will constantly be changing as our interests do too, because now we have the technology to support us continuing to evolve in that way. I hope you enjoyed this video, not only understanding what jobs are going to continue to be in demand, but also understanding that yes, there are jobs that will be taken away from us, but how can we navigate that in the best way possible? If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It really supports me. And also leave in the comments other questions you have that you want me to answer. I answer every single question you leave in the comments, so leave them down below, and I'll see you soon. Thanks, everyone.